We are Kim Philando High School Cross Country Postseason Squad. We're at Hayward High School.
And we're doing a mystery fartlek through the course. We get different slips of times, and we don't really know what the others have. And it's just kind of like random surges, and you kind of like get to trick each other.
Everyone has a couple slips of paper saying what strides they're doing. And throughout the 15 minutes, you have 14 random surges of random speeds at random times.
Your time, you're gonna start like surging to a certain pace, but no one else knows when you're surging, so you have to like follow the person who's surging.
I actually think it's a pretty good course because it's relatively flat with like a couple uphills, so if you're good at uphills, you can like pass people.
I like it, it's a good course, it's pretty flat, it's just really muddy and really repetitive. I like that the hill isn't very steep, and then at the top of the hill it is like flat and then goes right downhill, and then you're flat for a while.
It's pretty flat until there's just one hill, really, that's the main one. The grass is pretty good, I'd say better than Hidden Valley. But yeah, it's a pretty flat course, which I like.
It's mostly flat, it's mostly loops. There is one hill, but I think personally the worst part of the hill is the downhill. So yeah, it's not too fun to run because you're just running on loops and it's really muddy and grassy, but it's not terrible.
Had a 1 mile surge at 45 seconds. That one was hard. And then I had a 2 mile, 15 seconds, and then slowly back down to recovery run pace.
Well, because the searches were pretty hard. I think we stayed pretty composed and we kind of trusted one another when going the easy pace, but also we pushed each other to go fast on the sprints.
That's it, respond, close those gaps. Come on, guys. It's no surge is gonna last forever. You gotta respond to it. Tighten up, Sid.
The workout was really good. It was fun. It was better than last time. My first surge was, it was 60 seconds up to a 5K pace and then holding that for 60 seconds. And that was really good. We did, the girls in my group got confused as to if we were supposed to go to the finish or not, so then we kind of had like stopped halfway through. And I was like, no, we're finishing. They're like, no, we're not finishing, so we got confused, but then we figured it out.
Everyone did well. I had Shay, Nicola, Cody, and Daisy, because I was just sick. And all of them did well. We all stuck together as a group.
Wake up, Clark! Cover the gap! Some space. Drive up, get off the ground.
Steak burrito sounds very fancy.
Yes.
And how did that go?
It was pretty good.
Are you ready for, is there a burrito coma coming up soon?
Yeah.
Will there be a nap in your future?
Yep. I'm gonna go home and take a big nap.
I noticed that Amalia, even though we came for burritos, and then we're trying to build team, you know, bonding, culture, that kind of stuff. She went ahead and got tacos. How do you feel about her commitment?
That was very upsetting.
How were your tacos?
They were delicious.
What kind of tacos were they?
They had carnitas and pinto beans and pico de gallo.
Where do you rank this particular burrito among burritos?
I'd give it a 5 out of 10. They didn't get enough salsa, guacamole, sour cream, or cheese. It was just a lot of like flour.
So you know the burritos come in a tortilla, right?
Yeah.
Maybe you should have gone for the bowl.
Yeah, I'm more of an enchilada person.
Oh, enchilada. They have enchiladas.
Trying to do team bonding.
The wet burrito.
I made it wet myself. I had the hot sauce on it. The hot sauce is good.
All right.
I ran out of hot sauce.
You describe your burrito before. How does this one rank?
This is definitely a 9 out of 10. I think last year was a little better, though. I think it went down a little bit of quality, though. It was good, though.
All right. And do you have is there a nap coming up? Or are you gonna
get I'm going home. I'm taking a big nap.
Coma,
a fiesta. Or siesta. Siesta. That was
siesta. Walk us through your burrito.
I got the super wet burrito. It was definitely the move. I think I got it last year. It was just as good.
What was your choice?
I got carne asada.
Carne asada. And what was the highlight ingredient beyond the meat?
I'd say the guac. The guac was pretty good.
What kind of non-meat products went into your...
No, it got meat.
You got a meat burrito?
I did. Because I was...
Are you a vegan?
No, I was vegetarian.
It's a big move for you.
Yeah, well, I have
a feeling about it?
Thing with iron. But it was really good, so
You had a thing with... You're talking about iron like you broke up with it. What was your thing with iron?
I don't know. We had some difficulties. She wasn't giving me what she needed. And obviously, results weren't great. But we've come to terms now, you know.
Excellent. Yeah. All right, so a 9 out of 10 on the burrito scale. Rachel?
I think my first half was like a 9, and then the second half was like a 7.
Is that because the burrito was just too much for you?
It lost the flavor.
I agree.
Did you put some hot sauce on?
No, I'm not a spicy
one. Nora, what was your burrito today?
I got a super burrito.
A super burrito? And what was the meat filling in your burrito?
I'm pretty sure chicken.
You're pretty sure?
I think it's chicken.
It was like cow tongue.
Did you not get
I know you got the beef tongue.
You didn't get
the
shoes?
Well, I just pointed at it. I wasn't sure which one.
Okay. Clark, you're not going to spill that in the car, right?
Oh, no, for fun. I'm respectful.
No, you're not. You're horrible.
You going to finish that before we get... Here we go. And how did you memorize it?
The drawing by memory that we did yesterday.
And who had the best drawing, do you think?
Me. Personal opinion.